How's it going, guys? This is Twister, and today I'm back with another GTA Online video. We finally got the Finance and Felony DLC. That was quite a tongue twister. And we are going to be buying one of the new supercars, and I'm actually going to go for, I think this Legendary Motorsport looks like it's being updated. I am going to go for the Vapid FMJ. So we got five new cars here, two new supercars. We got the Vapid FMJ. We finally know the name for it. It costs 1.75 million, as you can see. I actually thought it was going to be a bit more expensive than that. I actually thought it was almost going to be 3 million, but it's 1.75 million. We do also have the Pegassi Reaper, the Grotti Best GT, GTS. We've got the Benefactor SUV and the Enus Windsor Drop. I'll be covering all of these other cars in separate videos. Maybe not the Enus Windsor Drop because it's not really a new car, and I did do a video on the regular Windsor. But in this one, I'm just going to go straight for the Vapid FMJ. I did say that this is the one I was most looking forward to. I think we should go for that 4 GT Blue. But yeah, it looks fantastic. I'm a big fan of the looks of this car already, and I haven't even bought it. But we are going to buy it right now. We got 4 million. It costs 1.75. Tinsel Tower is where I'm at right now. So yeah, damn, we're down to 2.2 million. This is on Xbox. I think I'm probably going to buy the cars on Xbox for videos. And then I actually want to focus on some of the CEO stuff on PS4. So I might actually have another video going up later today, possibly. I won't promise, but I will try and get it done because I really do want to check out some of the CEO stuff. But actually jumping straight into it, I did want to buy and fully upgrade and give you guys a car showcase on the Vapid FMJ supercar. So we have just bought that. It will be delivered pretty soon. So I'll be right back with you guys when we got the Vapid FMJ. Yo, here we go. We got the Vapid FMJ, and I gotta say, this thing, it looks pretty stunning. It's super, super cool. You'll see if we can get an angle. Look at, like, I don't know what to call that kind of side panel thing where you got the gap to the rear end of the car. It looks so good. I just want to jump in this thing, drive it into the customs, fully upgrade this. Man, it already looks cool, and I can't wait to see what it'll look like when we get our paint job on it, when we get some modifications on it. Unfortunately, it is night. I wanted it to be day so you could just properly see it in the daylight whilst we drive it around, but hopefully I'll get like a little preview or an intro or something at the start of the video to give you guys a nice little showcase thing. But yeah, we're gonna go straight into LS Customs, see what we can do with the upgrades. It looks fantastic already. You can see the sides of this car. It's completely unique. I love it on the 4 GT. It looks great on this car. The Aston Martin Vulcan, the front end as well. It all fits pretty nicely, so I think we'll just go straight in with all the upgrades. I maybe won't bother with armor. We'll get the performance mods, race brakes. Right, we'll see what bumpers we got. We got just some colour change. For now, I might go with carbon fibre. You can do matte black or carbon. I think I'll actually just go matte black for the bumper trim. Engine upgrades, of course. Horn explosives. We'll get some xenon lights, but I don't think I'll bother with neon lights in this one. Yellow and black rear plate. We'll get onto the respray, and I did say I wanted to do kind of like a Ford GT blue, so that's got to go down to the blue options. We'll see what goes well with it. I think maybe just a dark blue, normal blue. I think probably a dark blue. From a couple of pictures that I saw, it looks like a dark blue works pretty nicely, but I don't know what we'll do for the pearlescent. We could just do racing blue or ultra blue to make it really pop with the bright blue, or even go diamond blue. Diamond blue looks quite cool. Mariner blue. To be honest, I think I'll just go with the ultra blue, make it as bright as we can, get that blue shine on the front. It looks really nice in this front part. But overall, the car is pretty stunning overall. Secondary colour, what have we got? We'll see what we got for metallic. Also, on this car, you can actually change the colour of the brakes. That's pretty cool. You could do that with one of the cars. I think it was the Valera. But it hasn't really been an option on any other cars apart from that. So it's nice that it's on this car as well. I don't think it's changing anything else. So yeah, secondary colour is the brake pads, brake disc. I'm not too sure. But I don't know what colour to go. Should we just match it with blue? I think we should just really match it with blue, to be honest. That works pretty cool. Don't really want to do anything like gold. Yeah, we'll just keep it blue. Crew emblem, don't need to do crew emblem. Roof, alright, we got some roof options. We've got roof scoop. We got secondary colour. GT scoop, primary colour, GT scoop. Oh, car with GT scoop. I don't think I'm going to do that. I think I'm going to keep the roof scoop. I like the way you can see the engine in the rear window anyway. So we'll just go for a standard roof scoop. What else? Spoiler. All right, so there's a few spoiler options here. We've got a low-level spoiler, high-level spoiler, a carbon wing, a GT wing, and an enhanced GT. All right. The GT wing. I definitely prefer the GT wings over the carbon wing. But overall, maybe these look a little bit nicer. I'm not too sure. Should we go with enhanced GT? Yeah, I think we'll just go for the enhanced GT one. I was hoping that this one would have an active spoiler. The active spoiler is such a good part about the T20, so I was kind of hoping that we'd have it on this car, but we don't, unfortunately, so we'll just go with that GT wing. Suspension, yeah, lower it all the way. Transmission upgrades, fully upgrade the race transmission. Turbo, tuning turbo, fully upgraded. Alright, so I actually like these stock wheels. They go pretty nicely. I wish you could just change the colour of them maybe a little bit, but I think they work quite nicely as chrome anyway. Maybe we'll see what any type of decent high-end rims look when they're blacked out. I'm not too sure it will look that good, to be fair. I mean, even having carbon rims, I'm not too big of a fan of. You could go matching with the carbon wing, the carbon front bumper option, carbon rims. You could get it all matching, but I just prefer the stock rims, so I will actually keep those on the vehicle. So yeah, we can't change the colour of them. We can't really go for any tyre designs. We can throw on bulletproof tyres and then pick a tyre smoke, but I think just leaving it as it is probably the best option so far. Windows, what do we got? I think we'll just finish it off with some light smoke. I think that is pretty much it for the Vapid FMJ. That's all the upgrades that we've covered. We'll exit, we'll take it back to the garage. I think I will have a bit of a drive for it. And then we'll obviously take it back into the garage and we'll get a final look at this thing. So yeah, it's a hella awesome car. Wow, first person. You can't really get a good view in first person. Nothing really special going on in the interior. But yeah, the first person feels quite restricted in this car. So I'll go back to exterior view. It feels a bit slidey. Maybe it doesn't have as much traction as the other supercars. That's just like a first impression. You can really slide this if you tried. Yeah, we'll go back to the garage, get a final look at this car. Super awesome. I really do like this one. Hopefully, I haven't seen any kind of performance videos of this car yet, but hopefully it is a really fast in terms of the other supercars, like the T20 Osiris. Hopefully it is up there. But yeah, guys, that is it for the Vapid FMJ. We fully upgraded it. Giving you guys a little bit of a showcase. We're in first person right now in the garage, just to have a little bit of a walk around. So yeah, that's the Vapid FMJ from the Finance and Felony DLC. Hopefully you guys have enjoyed this video. Hopefully you guys are enjoying the DLC so far. Let me know your thoughts on it. Let me know your thoughts on this car. Like I mentioned before, I'll plan on doing some of the CEO stuff for you guys. Get some videos done on that, because the CEO stuff looks really, really interesting. Cannot wait to get started on that. And yeah, hopefully you've enjoyed this video. Leave a like rating if you have enjoyed. Subscribe to the channel if you are new. And I'll hopefully see you all on my next video. See you later, guys.